As you can see in this image, Layla's got her eyes closed. She's sort of squinting. But if you've taken enough images all at the same time, and you've got another image of Layla with her head turned in the same direction in the same light, you could always transplant her eyes from another image into that one. Thereby, you can open her eyes, and you're going to need to use a layer to do it. I have such an image here, which I prepared earlier. Let's just bring that into Photoshop. There it is. Make it a bit bigger. And here you can see little Layla's got her eyes open. And I think this picture would look really quite nice if she had her eyes open. As with everything in Photoshop, nothing is standalone. You use it in conjunction with other tools. It's a big box of tools, and you mix and match the tools to get what you want. And there is no one way of doing it. You know, you could go to the shops by one route or another, but you'll still arrive at the same shops. So let's say we're going to take these eyes from this picture and put them into that picture. Let's go to this one. First of all, we need to cut those eyes out. Well, I'm going to do it using this marquee tool, the freehand marquee tool. You can set some feathering. I'm just going to put 5 in there. I'm not going on about feathering because this is about layers. This isn't about selection tools, but we do have a video about selection tools. If you want to go and watch that, that will explain what I've just done. So let's just draw around Layla's eyes like this. Let's just take a little crop around here, around Layla's eyes. There we go. Now what we want to do is to put those eyes into this picture. Well, there's various ways you can do it. So one way would be to simply go edit, copy, and then go to the other picture and go edit, paste. And there you go. You can see those eyes have appeared here. And if you look on the right, you see there's a new layer, and filling up the little thumbnail is a close-up of Layla's eyes. Now you can rename that and call that eyes. I mean, with only 2 layers to work with, hopefully you're not going to lose track. Not even I could manage to do that. Get hold of the little move tool. We can move those eyes around, and I think you can see already, look, we're almost got that fixed, but it looks a little weird, doesn't it? The great thing here is we can make this eyes layer disappear. So I can just go like that, and I can sort of see what's going on. Another thing you can do is in this little panel here where it says opacity, next to it, it says 100%. So another route to finding out where to position those eyes would be to reduce the opacity of that layer. And you can see it's sort of blending the two together. They're going a bit transparent. So you could use the opacity tool. Let's set it at about 74%. And then I could move these eyes around until they seem to line up in just the right place. You can then use the transform tool, because they are obviously too big and the line of her nose isn't correct. If I go Control T, I've got a transform tool. And by holding the Shift key, I can just pull that in a bit so that it's a bit smaller, like that, and just kind of move them around until they look like they're in about the right place. Something I find very useful for this, actually, I'm going to apply that because that's about right. I'm going to put the opacity back up because I prefer, and this is personal taste, to just flick between the two. Now I can see that these eyes need rotating clockwise a little bit. So if I do Control T, transform tool, hover over the top right hand corner, I can just kind of rotate those a bit and kind of make the line of her nose line up. There we go. Look, you see it's lining up with her nose. Double click in there to apply it and just have a little look. Right, we've almost got it right, haven't we? She's almost blinking at us. But again, those eyes are still a little bit too big. Control T, just take them down a bit. You just work a little bit at a time like that. Just very carefully. Look, we're almost there, aren't we? I'd say they're about right, actually. I might just inch them down a bit. I'm going to use the arrows just to do this. One sort of pixel or two at a time. That's a bit better. And again, I'd say that's about right. You can also see, though, that there's a little bit of a line going on where the new eyes meet the original picture. Well, if we go into adjust our levels, again, this is another film. I'm not going on about this, but you see those eyes are brighter than the original picture. So let's just make those eyes a little bit darker. And if you preview it, I think you can see that I've now got the skin tones matching pretty much. Let's just put a bit more contrast in there, lift that up a bit. I've made that too bright. Make that a bit darker. What am I doing wrong? I've got the preview switched off. That's what I'm doing wrong. Idiot. So that's too bright. Take that down a bit until it just sort of blends in. There we go. I'd say that's pretty close. Like that. Click OK. You can, of course, then zoom in and you can remove bits of a layer. If I remove the background layer, you can see we've just got the eyes, but we've positioned them in exactly the right place. But if I look over here, there's a bit of an overlap going on, which isn't very nice. So you can get your eraser tool and just remove the bit of the eyes layer that you don't want. Let's make the brush a bit bigger, make it a bit softer. I'm going to do this fairly roughly because I don't want to spend too long on it. But you see, I can now erase this little bit of overlap that we don't want. Here we go, like that. But the hair, which is behind on the other image, is still there, you see. So we haven't erased anything over here. If I put the eraser over here, it's not going to make any difference because in that area of the layer we're working in, there isn't anything. You see, I'm actually trying to erase where nothing exists. So that's why it's so powerful. You can blend things together and make stuff look really great. Take it on to a slightly higher level. You could, of course, adjust the opacity of the brush. We really don't need this area here. All we really want are the eyes in there. So, you know, I could just kind of start blending this in like this. And this is one of the great powers of working with levels. You see, I can just sort of blend things in until they work nicely and you can't see lots of messy stuff going on. There is a little bit of messy stuff going on. That's better. There we go. You can see there's a double eyelash there. Now that can be taken out using a cloning tool, but we're not going into that. If we put that back to full size, I think you can see Layla has now got her eyes open and she'll blink at you. So there's one very, very practical use of layers. You couldn't do that if it wasn't possible to create another layer to put something on and move the different elements about and line them up. How do you finish off? We've created that, we've got two layers. So now all we need to do is to combine those two layers into one image. We go back into our little arrow drop down menu here and you click flatten image. And that has now merged the two together into one background layer. Now all you have to do is you can either just save it or you can save it as a copy. You could call that Layla Eyes Open. And then that could be the one that you are going to put on Facebook or email to someone or print big and pop it on the wall. Hope that's got you thinking about layers a bit and sort of opened your eyes to the possibilities of them. And we'll go into some of the more complex things that you find down here, such as these things, the adjustment layers, in another film. Go and have an explore around your layers palette. You can't harm anything. This is the great thing. Just go and play with it, start experimenting with it, and hopefully new possibilities will open up for you all on their own.